Beloved, we are so happy to come to you through this media this Sunday to bring you the message from Paroisse du Plateau, Temple du Centenaire, here in Congo Brazzaville, Central Africa. It's always a pleasure, really, to be able to communicate with you. Temples and church buildings around the world have been closed down because of the lockdown, but that doesn't prevent us from sharing the word of God. And in fact, as I was telling a pastor a few moments ago, I told him that the audience of the people who have been listening to the word of God has increased as compared to the people that attend church services or services in a temple. So there are so millions and millions of people are watching. And I thank God for that, because this is a way that just God wants us to communicate, really. Now let's read some opening scripture from Psalm 24. Just part of it, not everything. The earth is the Lord's, and everything in it, the world and all who live in it. For he founded it on the seas and established it on the waters. Who may ascend the mountain of the Lord? Who may stand in his holy place? The one who has clean hands and a pure heart, who does not trust in an idol or swear by a false god. They will receive blessing from the Lord and vindication from God, the Savior. Beloved, we can expect so many from our Father this morning, because he's going to bless and he's going to deliver and he's going to heal. He's going to achieve his purpose this morning. Let's pray. Father, we thank you and give you all the glory and all the honor. Thank you for being our Father, for adopting us as your sons and daughters, just because of Jesus Christ, the firstborn. Lord, we are co-heirs of Jesus Christ. We inherit your kingdom through Jesus Christ, and we bless you for it. We thank you for Jesus Christ, who died and sacrificed his life for us, so that I, my brother, and my sister could be saved. We commit this service into your hands, O Lord. We pray that everything may go well, that nothing may go wrong, Father. We commit, yes, our praise group. We commit the preacher. We commit the technician, the sound engineer, the cameraman, and everything, the gospel singers. We commit everything, Lord, into your hand and to your spirit, so that we can have a very beautiful service that will be pleasing to you, and that will also be pleasing to us. In the name of Jesus, amen. I'm going to turn to our worship group, our praise group, and they're about four. We have Papa Brill here, Brother Brill, Brother Gusty. We have a sister there. I don't master the name very well. And we also have, yes, Brother Jenny Dorr. They're going to give us a very beautiful hymn.
Hallelujah. You are the Lamb of God, O Jesus Christ. The Lord God Almighty reigns.
Yes, people of God, holy is the Lamb. Holy. Holy is the Lamb. The Lamb is holy. Our Father is holy. And you see, we read in Galatians chapter 5, verses 24 and 25. This is what we read. Those who belong to Christ Jesus have crucified the flesh with his passions and desires. Since we live by the Spirit, let us keep step with the Spirit. We are God's people. We belong to God. And those who belong to God, who belong to Jesus, must walk by the Spirit. Sometimes this is not the case, really. Sometimes we find ourselves not walking by the Spirit. We walk by our desires. We walk by the flesh. We walk by so many bad things. But because God wants us to be holy, we have to take a few minutes to confess. Because really, I'm a sinner. I cannot deny that. So are you. So let's take this minute to try to raise this prayer. Pray with me. Pray with me. Pray with me. Pray. Examine yourself. Try to see for yourself. Maybe there's something that you did wrong in the course of the past week or maybe before that. Let's ask God to forgive us. Let's pray. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you again for accepting us as your children. We are your children, and we are proud to be your children, but not when we are sinning, not when we disgrace you, not when we walk in sin, not when we do things which are contrary to your will. No, Lord, we want to be holy like you are holy. But you see the way we walk, sinful walks. And that's why we take this time, we take this minute, oh Father, to look down on us, to look at us. Look at us now, oh Lord. You see the different bad things. You see the impurities of our hearts. You see our sinfulness. You name it, oh Lord, because you see it so clearly, because it's a flashing before you. My sins and the sins of my brothers and sisters are flashing before your throne. Lord, because you see them flashing, we pray in the name of Jesus that you may cleanse us from any transgressions, from any impurities, from any uncleanness, from any sin that is harming us, that is harming the relationship that exists between you and us. Forgive us, Father, the sins of our eyes, the sins of our flesh, the sins of our talk, the sins of our tongues. Forgive, Father, in the name of Jesus. Amen. We're going to turn to the praise group again, to the worship group. They're going to give us a hymn.
Hallelujah. We're going to sing the greatness of our God because we have a great Father, a great God, the one who rules the nation. Hallelujah.
God.
Thank you, praise team. Indeed, our God is great. He's so great. He's so great because of his works. His works are so great. Well, it's about time we listen to the word of God that I will be bringing to you. But before that, I'm going to ask Brother Jenny Doll to say a prayer to God, a prayer of enlightenment.
Seigneur, notre Dieu, notre Père, nous voici à l'heure où nous voulons, Seigneur notre Dieu, disposer nos assiettes pour recevoir cette nourriture qui donne la vie. Comme l'avait dit Esaïe, venez acheter, même celui qui n'a pas d'argent, qu'il vienne, ô Seigneur. Oh, dispose, Seigneur, nos cœurs et utilise puissamment ton serviteur. Que cette parole, Seigneur notre Dieu, qui sera prêchée en ces jours, sois, Seigneur notre Dieu, la parole que toi tu t'es choisie. Cette parole, Seigneur, que tu veux, ou que tu voudrais, Seigneur notre Dieu, que nous puissions écouter en ce jour. Oui, elle est là pour étancher notre soif. Elle est là pour briser les chaînes. Elle est là, Seigneur, pour guérir. Mais aussi, elle est là pour pardonner. Merci. Comme l'avait dit Samuel, parle. Nous voulons t'écouter. Au nom de Jésus. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Brother Jenny Doll.
Merci beaucoup, frère Jenny Doll.
Our message for today is taken from Proverbs chapter 26, verse 11.
Notre message d'aujourd'hui est tiré du livre de Proverbes 26, verset 11.
Now I must tell you.
Je dois vous dire.
Try to take it.
Essayez de prendre ce message au sérieux.
The message may be hard.
Le message, c'est peu que ça soit dur.
Because I gave it a title.
Parce que j'ai intitulé ce message
You are not a dog.
Tu n'es pas un chien.
So let me read it before we talk about it.
Permettez-moi d'abord de lire avant que nous puissions en parler.
Proverbs chapter 26 verse 11.
Proverbe 26 verset 11.
As a dog returns to its vomit, so fools repeat their folly.
Le chien retourne à ce qu'il a vomi et le sot renouvelle ses bêtises.
Let me read that again.
Permettez-moi de lire cela une fois de plus.
As a dog returns to its vomit, so fools repeat their folly.
Le chien retourne à ce qu'il a vomi et le sot renouvelle ses bêtises.
Beloved, I don't know, but naturally, I don't like dogs.
Je ne sais pas connaître. Naturellement, je n'aime pas les chiens. Je ne sais pas pourquoi, mais je n'aime pas les chiens.
I tried to buy puppies.
J'ai essayé d'acheter les chiots.
I brought them up.
Je les ai élevés.
Bred them.
Je les ai nourris.
Feeding them.
Je les ai nourris.
Buying them meat sometimes.
On les achetait de la viande parfois.
Chicken.
Du poulet.
Fish,
du poisson.
And giving them, spending money.
J'ai dépensé de l'argent pour eux.
But there's one thing that I didn't like about dogs.
Mais il y a une chose que je n'ai jamais aimé chez les chiens.
I bought two of them in my life.
J'en ai déjà acheté deux fois.
And the last one that I bought, I gave it away.
Le tout dernier que j'ai acheté, j'en ai partagé.
You may say why.
Vous pouvez dire, mais pourquoi?
You buy dogs.
Vous achetez du chien.
And then you give them away.
Ensuite, vous le partagez.
Of course, there are people who find that dogs are very faithful.
Mais il y a des gens qui trouvent, qui pensent que les chiens sont très fidèles.
This is what I think also.
C'est ce que je pense aussi.
Despite the defect that I saw in my dog.
Malgré le défaut que j'ai vu dans mon chien.
I saw that dogs were very faithful.
J'ai vu que les chiens étaient très fidèles.
Both my dogs were following me.
Mes chiens me suivaient.
If I go to the kitchen,
si je vais à la cuisine,
my dog follows me to the kitchen.
Mes chiens me suivaient à la cuisine.
Or if I go outside,
si je sors,
my dog follows me outside.
Mes chiens venaient après moi dehors.
And when I'm coming,
lorsque je rentre,
and I go out and I come
lorsque
back,
je sors et je rentre,
my dog is barking and very happy.
Mon chien est en train d'aboyer, il est très
content. The master is coming.
Parce que le maître arrive.
But as I said,
et comme je l'ai dit en
avant, there is something I didn't like about my dog.
Il y a une chose que je n'ai pas aimé chez mon chien.
One day I fed one of the dogs.
Un jour, j'ai nourri l'un de ses chiens.
He ate and ate and ate and ate up his food.
Il a mangé, mangé, beaucoup mangé.
And at the end of it all,
et à la fin de tout,
he vomited.
Il a vomi.
Because he ate, I'm saying he, it doesn't matter, eat or he.
So le chien a vomi.
Okay, the dog vomited.
Le chien a vomi.
And I said, hey, what's this?
Yeah, c'est quoi ça?
And I looked at the vomit. So
j'ai vu le vomi sur le chien.
I didn't want to see.
Je voulais même pas le voir.
Terrible.
C'était terrible.
But what I saw the dog do.
Mais ce que j'ai vu le chien en train de faire.
Was return to his own vomit.
Il est retourné chez vomi.
Oh, I almost collapsed.
J'ai failli me fondre.
It was outside.
C'était dehors.
It went back.
Et c'est sorti.
And it started licking.
Il a commencé à lécher encore. Lécher ses propres vomissures.
I said, wow.
J'ai dit, pourquoi?
What's this?
C'est quoi ça?
I gave him so much food.
Je t'ai donné beaucoup à manger.
He gave so much. He ate so much.
Il a tant mangé.
And now he has vomited.
Et maintenant il a vomi ce qu'il a mangé.
He's going back to his vomit.
Il veut manger encore ce qu'il a vomi.
And when I saw this in the Bible,
et lorsque j'ai vu ceci dans la Bible,
as a dog returns to its vomit,
comme le chien retourne à ce qu'il a vomi,
so fools return to their folly.
Le sot aussi renouvelle ses bêtises.
But why?
Mais pourquoi cela?
Isn't this the case of us?
N'est-ce pas le cas de nous, pour nous, les chrétiens d'aujourd'hui?
What can be a vomit for us here?
Qu'est-ce qui peut être vomissure pour nous?
The vomit can be a sin that you have repented for.
La vomissure, si peut être ce péché que tu t'es repenti.
So now you vomited this.
Tu as vomi ce péché.
You saw that, you know, what you were doing was not a very good thing. So you say, okay, I'm God, I repent.
Tu t'es rendu compte ce que tu faisais était mal. Tu dis, Seigneur, je me repens.
Perhaps you are a thief.
Peut-être que tu es un voleur.
And you stole somebody's goods.
Et tu as volé les biens de quelqu'un.
And after that, you know, your conscience was not so cool, was not quiet.
Après cela, tu n'avais pas la conscience tranquille.
And you said to yourself, I have to confess, oh God,
tu
forgive
dit,
me.
Oh, je dois confesser, oh Dieu, pardonne-moi.
Okay, and the Lord forgave you.
Bien que le Seigneur te pardonne.
But,
mais,
the God having forgiven you,
le Dieu qui t'a pardonné,
after 2 weeks or 3 weeks or 4 weeks,
après 3 semaines ou 4 semaines,
or 1 month,
ou 1 mois,
here you are.
Tu te voilà encore.
This is stealing that you vomited.
La chose que tu as vomi.
This is stealing that you vomited.
La chose, ce que tu as vomi. Le vol que tu as vomi.
Very good. You vomited.
Tu as vomi.
Of stealing.
L'esprit du vol.
You come back to it.
Tu reviens encore sur ça.
Maybe it's adultery.
Peut-être c'est adultère.
You committed adultery.
Tu as commis l'adultère.
And you repented.
Tu t'es repenti.
Perhaps you even told your wife.
Peut-être que tu as même dit à ta femme.
Perhaps you even said, "Forgive me, my husband."
Peut-être que tu as dit à ton mari, pardonne-moi.
Okay, and your wife or your husband forgave you.
Ton mari ou ta femme te pardonne.
Because he loves you.
Parce qu'il t'aime.
Though it would have been possible for him to divorce you.
Bien que ça c'était l'occasion pour lui de divorcer.
But because he loved
mais
you.
Parce qu'il t'aime.
Or because she
loves you. Parce qu'elle t'aime.
Okay, he or she forgave you.
Ou elle t'a pardonné.
And you continue to live together.
Et que voilà, vous continuez à vivre ensemble.
But after some time,
après quelque temps,
because this sin,
parce que ce péché,
yes, is in you,
est en toi.
You vomited it, yes.
Tu l'as vomi, bien sûr.
But you return to it.
Et tu repars vers ce
because
péché.
You repeated to do the same.
Parce
you
que
repeated
tu,
the same
parce
thing.
Que tu fais la répète, tu fais la même chose.
My brother, that is why I'm saying.
Mon frère, voilà pourquoi je dis.
You are not a dog.
Tu n'es pas un chien.
You are not a dog.
Tu n'es pas un chien.
You are a man.
Tu es un homme.
You are a woman.
Tu es une femme.
And more than that, you are a child of God.
Et au-delà de tout, tu es enfant de Dieu.
He wants us to be holy.
Il veut que nous soyons saints.
He wants us to have clean hands.
Il veut que nous ayons des mains propres.
He wants us to have pure hearts.
Il veut que nous ayons des cœurs purs.
He expects us to be holy.
Ce qu'il attend de nous, c'est la sainteté.
God says I'm holy.
Dieu dit je suis saint.
And I want you to be holy.
Ce que je veux de vous, c'est aussi que vous soyez saint.
But what I see what you're doing.
Ce que je vous vois faire.
Just behaving like dogs.
Vous comportez comme si vous étiez des chiens.
You go back to your vomit.
Vous retournez vers vos vomissures.
I want you.
Je veux que vous.
To stop really.
Si arrêtez.
Now if I ask you this question, I don't know if it makes sense. I don't know if it makes sense what I'm saying.
Je ne sais pas ce que je dis a un sens.
But I think it makes sense to you who go back
cela
to your sin all the time.
Cela a de sens pour vous, vous qui partez répéter les mêmes péchés de temps en temps.
I think you're hearing something.
J'espère que vous entendez quelque chose.
And I think you agree with me.
J'espère que vous accordez avec moi.
This is really a problem.
C'est vraiment un problème.
This is a problem really.
C'est un problème.
Because if you continue to sin.
Parce que si vous continuez à pécher.
You continue to sin and do the same thing.
Si vous continuez à faire les mêmes choses.
I know what we say when we come to God.
Je sais ce que nous disons souvent lorsque nous venons à Dieu.
Yes, when these people receive the altar call.
Lorsque ils reçoivent l'appel,
when people receive the altar call.
Lorsqu'ils reçoivent l'appel de Dieu.
When people receive the call of God.
Lorsque les gens reçoivent l'appel de Dieu.
And they come to the altar.
Et ils viennent à l'autel.
What do they say?
Qu'est-ce qu'ils disent?
They say, I forsake sin to follow Jesus.
Ils disent, j'abandonne les péchés pour suivre Jésus.
Ah, that's very easily said.
C'est très facile à dire.
But it's very difficult to do.
Mais c'est très difficile à appliquer.
Very hard.
C'est très dur.
To forsake sin.
Pour abandonner les péchés.
And I think that's the reason why God said,
je pense que c'est la raison pour laquelle Dieu a dit,
if you claim that you have no sins,
si vous dites que vous n'avez pas de péché,
you're making me a liar.
Vous me rendez menteur.
But I'm not a liar.
Je ne suis pas un menteur.
You see,
vous voyez?
So it means that God knows our sinful nature.
Cela veut dire que Dieu connaît notre nature de péché.
That it is difficult for us, really, really.
C'est vraiment difficile pour nous.
If it's not by the Holy Spirit,
si ce n'est pas grâce à l'aide du Saint-Esprit,
it's difficult for us, really, to be holy.
C'est difficile pour nous d'être saints.
That is why Paul.
Voilà pourquoi Paul.
He understood this.
Il a compris cela.
He was in the same situation.
Il était dans la même situation.
You may think, oh, Paul. Wrote one third of the New Testament.
Vous voyez que Paul a écrit un tiers du Nouveau Testament.
And he too, he went through this.
Lui aussi, il est passé parmi ces choses.
Yes,
à travers ces
yes,
choses.
Yes.
Oui.
He too, he went through this.
Lui aussi, il est passé par là.
Because he said, oh God, who will deliver me?
Parce qu'il a dit, Dieu, qui va me délivrer?
From this law of sin.
De ce péché, de ce fardeau.
Who can deliver me?
Qui peut m'en délivrer?
The good thing that I want to do, I don't do.
La bonne chose que je veux faire, mais je ne le fais pas.
But what I don't want to do, that is what I do.
Ce que je n'aime pas faire, c'est ce que je fais.
Oh, who can deliver me?
Oh, qui peut me délivrer?
Is that your prayer?
Est-ce là votre prière?
Indeed, there is somebody who can deliver.
Bien sûr qu'il y a quelqu'un qui peut vous délivrer.
And this person is Jesus Christ
et
himself.
Cette personne, c'est Jésus-Christ lui-même.
This person who can deliver.
C'est cette personne qui peut nous délivrer.
Is the Holy Spirit.
C'est le Saint-Esprit.
The Holy Spirit.
Le Saint-Esprit.
The Holy Spirit.
Le Saint-Esprit.
But how can we really? Yes, how can the Holy Spirit deliver us from sin.
Comment est-ce que le Saint-Esprit peut nous délivrer du péché?
You see, sometimes we read the Bible.
Parfois, nous lisons la Bible.
And we read it intellectually.
Et nous lisons la Bible de façon intellectuelle.
Let me tell you this: as long as we read the Bible intellectually,
laissez-moi vous dire, aussi longtemps que nous lisons la Bible de façon intellectuelle,
change may not come in you.
Il se peut qu'il n'y ait pas de changement en vous.
Because when we read the Bible,
parce que lorsque nous lisons la Bible,
we must really meditate.
Nous devons sincèrement la méditer.
Because it's when we meditate that the Holy Spirit works.
C'est seulement lorsque nous méditons que le Saint-Esprit est à l'œuvre.
If you take a verse,
si vous prenez un verset
in the Bible,
dans la Bible,
and you read it like intellectually or mechanically,
vous lisez cela intellectuellement,
or mechanically,
de façon mécanique,
I can tell you that you may not have the result.
Je peux vous dire que peut-être que vous n'aurez pas le résultat attendu.
But if you sit down,
mais si vous vous asseyez,
and you begin to look at the verse,
et vous commencez à examiner le verset,
word by word,
mot par mot à mot,
sentence by sentence,
verset par verset,
and you meditate on that,
et vous méditez sur ce
verset, and very prayerfully at the same time you are praying as you are reading,
et au même moment vous priez pendant que vous lisez,
I can tell you,
je peux vous dire,
That reading is going to be more effective,
que cette lecture aura beaucoup d'effet,
than if you read,
que lorsque vous lisez
even
façon,
a whole chapter,
même si vous lisez tout le chapitre.
Sometimes perhaps it's better to read just one verse and meditate.
Parfois c'est même mieux de lire un verset et méditer là-dessus.
Than you read a whole chapter,
que de lire tout le chapitre,
without meditating,
sans pourtant le méditer,
and asking God,
et demander à Dieu,
speak to me through this verse,
parle à moi à travers ce
speak
verset,
to me through this
parle à moi à travers ce
what
verset.
Do you want to tell me through
Qu'est-ce
this
que
verse?
Tu veux me dire à travers ce verset?
That is how.
C'est pourquoi.
Very easily.
C'est facilement.
Your mind can be renewed.
Ta pensée sera renouvelée facilement.
One thing that I do when I face temptation.
Une chose que je fais lorsque je suis face à la tentation.
And to run away really from sin.
De m'éloigner du péché.
When I'm tempted, I'm thinking of the Word of God.
Lorsque je suis tenté, je pense à la Parole de Dieu.
I have a book.
J'ai un livre.
Where when I read the Bible, I write some verses which are very important.
Lorsque je lis la Bible, j'écris les versets qui me marquent.
My copybook is there. My
Mon cahier est juste là-bas.
And that is at least even the 20th copybook.
Je crois que c'est même le 20e livre cahier que j'ai.
That is where when I read the Bible.
Donc, okay, lorsque je lis la Bible.
And when I see a verse.
Lorsque je vois un verset.
Oh, I write down the verse.
J'inscris le verset.
Not just writing.
Pas seulement écrire.
Not just reading.
Pas seulement lire.
Not just writing.
Pas seulement écrire.
But meditating.
Mais aussi méditer.
And not only meditating.
Pas seulement méditer.
But praying over that.
Prier sur ça.
You see.
Vous voyez?
That and when I'm tempted,
lorsque je suis face à la tentation,
I go back.
Je retourne vers
I go back.
De notes.
What does the word say?
Que me dit les paroles
concerning this?
Concernant ceci,
I'm not going to do it.
Je ne vais pas le faire.
I refuse to do it.
Je refuse de le
because
faire.
Because the spirit,
parce que l'esprit,
the word of God,
et la parole de Dieu,
not allow me to
ne
do
me
it.
Permet pas de
I'm
le faire.
I'm not going to do
je
it.
Je vais pas le faire.
I'm going to resist it.
Je vais résister.
I'm not going to fall in sin.
Je ne vais pas tomber dans
this
le péché.
This temptation, I'm not going to succumb to it.
Je ne vais pas succomber.
I'm going to stand up.
Je vais tenir.
And I'm going to resist.
Je vais résister.
And I'm going to be firm.
Je serai ferme.
Because I don't want to disgrace.
Je veux pas
the name of Jesus.
La
I don't
Jésus.
Want to disgrace my Lord.
Donner
and
la
I don't
la
want
Jésus
to disgrace my Savior.
Je veux pas aussi.
That is how.
Voilà pourquoi.
Perhaps.
Peut-être.
Yes, if you try that.
Si vous essayez.
Perhaps.
Cela, peut-être.
Perhaps.
Peut-être.
That may prevent you
cela va vous
from
empêcher.
Going back to your vomit.
De retourner vers
so
vos vomit.
Afin que vous robbez.
Si vous êtes voleur.
You may not rob again.
Vous ne serez plus volé.
If you were a fornicator.
Si vous étiez en train de commettre.
You may not fornicate again.
Vous ne serez plus retombé.
If you were a liar.
C'était un menteur.
You may not lie again.
Plus mentir.
If you were, you know, talking and insulting people,
qui insultait les gens n'importe comment,
so that you may not go back to that.
Afin que vous puissiez arrêter.
Is there in your lifetime anything you have, any sin you have stopped doing?
Y a-t-il quelque chose dont tu avais un péché avec lequel tu as arrêté? C'est ça, tu as cessé de commettre?
Can you name even one?
Est-ce que tu peux citer?
Can you tell me? I used to be like this. I used to be like this, but now I'm no longer like that. I'm now like.
Vous pouvez me dire, d'avant je faisais ceci, je faisais, mais là j'ai changé, je ne suis plus la même personne.
Oh, if you are doing that.
Ou si vous le faites.
No. If you have a change.
Si vous avez changé.
Oh, then glory to God.
Oh, gloire à Dieu.
And if you can change from today.
Si vous pouvez changer à partir d'aujourd'hui.
Glory to God.
Gloire à Dieu.
If you don't go back to your vomit,
vous ne retournez plus vers vos
vomissons.
Gloire à Dieu.
The angels in heaven,
les anges dans les
going
cieux,
to be are going to glorify God the Father.
Vont glorifier Dieu le Père.
God is going to bless you.
Et Dieu va vous bénir.
Because you may have, you will have resisted temptation.
Parce que vous avez résisté contre
you will have the temptation to steal again.
Et vous n'aurez plus à voler.
You will have resisted the temptation to steal.
La tentation du vol,
and to do any bad thing.
Et aussi à faire toute autre mauvaise chose.
Punishment is so much.
Vous savez, il y a trop de punitions.
Let's read from 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 22.
Lisons dans 2 Timothée chapitre 2 verset 22.
That is where we are being called to flee the evil.
C'est là où on nous appelle
evil
nous
desires, evil desires.
Au désir de la chair.
It says this.
Ça dit ceci.
Flee the evil desires of youth.
Flee.